I'm already talking to millionaires. Yeah, so
I'm blocking
the small boy in me. Just permit me to just share 10 minutes with you on why we're here. I'm super excited about Blockchain Center. Normally, when people tell me they want to invite me for something, I first do a check twice, and then I bring my bill. When Toby called and said, Chris, I want you to be in Ibadan, I said, I need to share the idea with me that Blockchain Center will launch it. And I'm like, this is what we've been waiting for in the space. Because we have thousands of people in the cryptocurrency space in Nigeria, and it seems like, see, we don't even know why we're here. Money is very, very important. Money has a way of giving us freedom, but also, when purpose is not done, that beauty is everything. I want to recognize the lead ambassador of Dash, Nigeria, Natalia Ruiz. He's also the founder of cryptocurrency Africa. These guys have done mighty stuff in the industry. And then my brother, the timid way in Nigeria, another person who is here. Let me quickly share something that will excite you all that will. I need a marker. 2008, 2009, when Satoshi began to start all these stories, I never discovered that it wasn't just about what Satoshi started or what Satoshi invented. It's been like, what's been the vision? This concentrated vision. What I'm sharing with you, we don't miss this point. Some of these early cyberpunks, the people who decided to start something what they call cryptography. And in the early days, what was their mission? Why did they start things like this? We know cryptography has to do with data storage, encryption, and all that. Now the question is, why were they doing things like this? Very simple. Because at the time, government, state, money needed to be separated. Even information. These things needed to be separated. Can you imagine? You will have a property of your own and the government has the license to confiscate it. You will have money in the bank and the government has full right to seize the money in the bank. So cyberpunks came up with their own program, encryptions and all these stuff. Now, I don't do a lot of these with codes, but I have basic knowledge writing codes. And these people decided to start having something where government will not have access to. Today, you will see somebody say there's money laundering going on, there is theft going on, terrorism going on, and they try to attribute it to certain individuals, and those things are not true. One of the greatest evils we see in the world today is permitting me to say this has been the government system. So these cyberpunks were on their own and said their mission is to have a separation where their property, their financial freedom, or their financial asset has nothing to do with the government. So let us create systems that will not give these people access as long as I have my private keys, as long as I have my own passport and everything, the government can do anything to this property. That's how these guys started. And today, one day, a man or a pseudonym or a group of people called Satoshi Nakamoto came up with all the researches they've done on encryption, cryptography, and data storage, and all those things, money, finance, and everything. And Bitcoin was born. And remember, Bitcoin came as an answer at the same period that we had the last financial crisis in the world. So Bitcoin was like, hey banks, we know you are crashing, but we are the new answer. And here the first application or the first open blockchain that is relevant in the world. Now I know the frenzy about people talking about different blockchains that will do this and that. Make no mistakes, blockchains are hard to scale. Blockchains are very complex and sometimes simple. And that's why the most robust today, the most secure today, the most assured, with all the capacity, with all the attacks that's taken, is the Bitcoin blockchain. And that's why everybody tries to copy one or two codes and want to use something to do like Bitcoin. So why are we here in the first place? Privacy. People want to have their own wealth. People don't want to open to tamper with what they're doing. You can imagine somebody is in Venezuela, and because he wants to travel out of the country, the government is seizing his papers, the government is seizing his funds, and he cannot travel, he's stranded. Somebody cannot transfer. The old USSR, maybe the nation is dissolving, and in the old USSR, the guy cannot convert his property or his money again because government has seized them. Same thing in Brazil. And they try to tell us that we, in the Bitcoin and the blockchain or the cryptocurrency industry, we are actually the one that may be used for drug trafficking, money laundering. Hey, let them not lie to you. Because this system, like Petro, this system has come to threaten. This system has come to challenge the existing system. I am somebody who likes everything that has to do with freedom. Cryptocurrency is simple. What are we promoting? The free market. What are we promoting? Freedom. Do you know, cryptocurrency as a whole, using Bitcoin as the pioneer of this revolution, is simple. It's about financial revolution, it's about social revolution, it's also a political revolution. Bitcoin is not just about how much we're making money. Money is so important. And that's why if the government of your country can control money supply, they can hold an entire nation hostage. They've done it in France. They've done it in Russia. They've done it in Venezuela. They've done it in Brazil. And the time when we had one time, when we were in this country, and we would go to the banks and want to collect money, and they would say, no money.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's freedom not limited like that. So now with the centralized technology, by saying, hey, instead of centralized systems, group of people determining the policy that will affect 140 million Nigerians or billions of people in the world, why don't they have something that will give power back to the people and do as you want? Humans can govern themselves with technology. So what are we seeing happening right away? We are seeing a shift from rulers. Now codes, protocols. In the Bitcoin blockchain, you can't come and tell me you did one back of there. Somebody has to verify transactions. There has to be nodes all over the world. You can't go and climb down on the blockchain and say, hey, we have a data center here. The other day, Almighty EFCC was hacked. Almighty EFCC. And for 9 solid years, the Bitcoin blockchain has been running 24/7, 365, 366 days. Uptime that no bank in the world can boast of. You make up one money, you want to transfer money, and they tell you network is bad. And not just because network is bad, because they are trying to limit transfer of money. I'm sorry to say this. I don't know how to go to banks. I don't. The last time I only use one bank account. So crypto made me very crazy that. My GT accounts that have unlimited transactions, I've never used them. I can't even remember my account number and all those things. And then the one I use, they still give me a limit on the money I can transfer. So for the first time in history, value can be transferred from anywhere in the world without any restriction. You wonder what's this thing we're talking about? Open source technology, a decentralized system where everyone can participate. Look at what Toby is doing to the blockchain center. Imagine the number of people. Imagine when you bring youth. Look at Steve, it is here. And this one partner with you. He just came back from Ghana. This guy just came back from Ghana. And their own blockchain is one of the fastest blockchain in the system. And people, because of what they, just like what you're doing on Facebook, and you're doing the same thing on Steve, and people are rewarded.